Hi children, welcome to biology classroom, class 9 biology, chapter 2, food through digestive tract. Don't forget to like, subscribe and share. Thank you in advance. Chapter 2, food through digestive tract. Here, we have to study about digestion and digestive system. First heading, nutrients and their function. Nutrients and what are their function? Carbohydrate, production of energy. It helps in producing energy that is needed for life activities. Protein, building up of the body, growth and development of the body. Fat, also providing energy like carbohydrate. Minerals, control life activities. Vitamins also control many life activities. And water is very essential. It is a medium for physiological actions that is taking place in our body. What is digestion? It is the process of converting complex food into simple absorbable form. Complex food is broken down into simple forms with the help of digestion process. Now let us see the human digestive system. This system helps in digestion process. It includes different parts like mouth. First part, this is the mouth. It leads to a pipe-like structure called esophagus. Esophagus then opens into stomach. Stomach then opens into small intestine. Small intestine is a highly coiled structure. Then it opens into large intestine. And large intestine finally opens out through anus. Digestive glands are also present here. Inside the mouth we can see what? Salivary gland. There are three pairs of salivary gland. And there is another gland, that is liver. Pancreas is also a gland. And one more structure you can see here, that is called a gallbladder. Next topic, food inside the mouth. What happens to food when it reaches inside the mouth? So in mouth we can see different structures like teeth, tongue and salivary glands. How many pairs of salivary glands? Three pairs. What is the function of teeth? Masticate the food. Masticate means chew the food. Break the food into smaller particles. Next one, tongue helps the teeth to masticate the food. Mix the food with saliva. It is helping to mix the food with saliva. Taste buds helps to sense the taste. We are feeling the taste with the help of taste buds. Salivary glands are producing saliva. Saliva is having many components and enzymes. They help in digestion process. Now there are 32 teeth which are of 4 different types. Which are the 4 different types of teeth? Incisor, canine, premolar and molar. Incisor helps to bite and cut the food. Canine helps to tear the food. Premolar helps to chew the food. Molar helps to chew the food. Next, structure of the teeth. Two types of teeth are given here, canine and molar. First one, first part, enamel. This is the enamel. What is the color? White in color. It is the hardest part and it is dead tissue. It is not living tissue. And this is called what? Dentine. Dentine is a living tissue. It forms the tooth. This part is actually called what? Tooth. And next part is pulp. Pulp is soft connective tissue. It contains blood vessel, lymph duct, nerve fibers, etc. And next part is cementum. Like a cement, okay. Calcium containing connective tissue. It contains calcium. It holds the tooth in the socket of the gum. It is fixing the tooth in gums. Gums means that is inside our mouth. Saliva, components and functions. What all components are seen inside the saliva? You can prepare a box like this. Gland, juice, components and function. What is the gland? Salivary gland. And it produces the juice, saliva. It contains components like mucus, lysozyme, salivary amylase. Lysozyme and salivary amylase are enzymes. What is the function of mucus? Make the food slimy for easy swallowing so that we are able to swallow the food. Lysozyme destroy the germs in our food. Salivary amylase is helping to convert starch into maltose. We are eating starch food that is converted to maltose with the help of salivary amylase. Then what is the chemistry behind sweet taste while chewing rice for a certain time without adding curry? What happens there? Salivary amylase enzyme converts starch that is present in rice to maltose. Maltose is a sugar. That is why we are feeling sweet taste when we chew rice without adding curry. That is, starch in rice is converted to maltose. It is a sugar with the help of salivary amylase enzyme. From the mouth, food reaches to esophagus. Tongue and palate make the food into balls. Food is made into small balls with the help of tongue and palate. Uvula closes the nasal cavity. Otherwise, food will reach the nose. So, uvula is closing the nasal cavity. And posterior part of the tongue allow the food to move over the epiglottis into the esophagus. Food is directly moving to the esophagus. It is not moving to the trachea. Epiglottis is preventing the movement of food into trachea. Trachea rises up and is closed. So food doesn't reaches the trachea and the lungs. Food directly reaches the stomach. This is how the food that we swallow enter exactly into the esophagus without entering the trachea. Then what is peristalsis? The food reaches the stomach by the wave-like movement of the walls of the esophagus. These movements are called a peristalsis. From the mouth, food is reaching the stomach through the esophagus. So, esophagus is moving like a wave. This will allow the food to move. So, that wave-like movement is called what? Peristalsis. Now, food is inside the stomach. Peristalsis in the stomach convert the food into a paste form. Stomach is also showing peristalsis. Food is changed into a paste-like form. Circular muscles present in the posterior part of the stomach keep the food for a specific time. Stomach contains circular muscle that will help to keep the food for a specific period so that digestion can occur inside the stomach. Now, what are the functions of components that is present in gastric juice? Here, you can prepare a table, gland, juice, components and function. Which gland, gastric juice. And which are the components? Pepsin enzyme, gastric lipase enzyme, hydrochloric acid, mucus. First one, pepsin enzyme. What is the function? It is converting protein present in the food into pepton. Gastric lipase enzyme is digesting the fat. Hydrochloric acid is destroying the germs present in food. It is also helping to regulate the pH. And mucus is protecting the stomach wall from the action of digestive juices. So mucus is actually protecting the stomach from the hydrochloric acid and other enzyme actions, etc. From the stomach, food now reaches the small intestine. Food in the small intestine. The completion of digestion and beginning of absorption takes place here. Digestion is completed and absorption begins from small intestine. Human intestine is 5 to 6 meters long. Hence, food moves very slowly through the small intestine. Not that point, okay? Now, how small intestine, liver and pancreas helps in digestion? We can study their components and function. Gland, juice, components and function. First gland, the largest gland, liver. What is the name of the juice? Bile. And it is stored in gallbladder. And it doesn't contain components. Function of bile is converting fat into smaller particle and also making the food alkaline. When the food mixes with hydrochloric acid, it becomes acidic. Now bile make it alkaline inside the small intestine. Now next gland, pancreas. It contains pancreatic juice. It contains three enzymes, pancreatic amylase, trypsin and pancreatic lipase. Pancreatic amylase converts starch into maltose. Maltose is a sugar. Trypsin converts protein into peptide. And pancreatic lipase converts fat into fatty acid and glycerol. Intestinal glands present in small intestine. It contains intestinal juice and it contains many enzymes. No need to study their names, okay? They help in converting maltose, lactose, sucrose into glucose, fructose and galactose. And also it helps to convert peptides into amino acids. Now, the digestion is over inside the small intestine. Digestion is over. End products are formed. So, we can see the nutrients here, which are the carbohydrate, protein and fat. And which are the end products formed after digestion. Carbohydrate. End products are glucose, fructose and galactose. After protein digestion, amino acids are formed. And after fat digestion, fatty acid and glycerol are formed. Which are the nutrients that do not undergo digestion? What could be the reason for this? We studied about 6 nutrients, but here we saw only 3 nutrients and their end products. So which are the nutrients that do not undergo digestion? They are water, minerals and vitamins. What is the reason? They are the simple substances which can be absorbed by our body directly. So no need of digestion for those molecules. Next structure, villi. They are finger-like projections seen inside the small intestine. They are covered with a single layer of cell. They are formed of single layer of cell. And they contain what? Blood capillaries and lacteal. And what are the functions of villi? What is the need of villi inside small intestine? For the absorption of nutrients and water. 90% of water is absorbed here. And it also increases the surface area of absorption. And it contains blood capillary and lacteal. Blood capillary absorb glucose, fructose, galactose, amino acids, etc. into the blood. Lacteal helps to absorb fatty acid and glycerol into the lymph. And there are different types of absorption method. Remember, absorption takes place inside the small intestine. Type, peculiarity and which are the nutrients absorbed. Let us see that. First type of absorption, simple diffusion. Movement of molecules from a region of higher concentration to lower concentration. Molecules are moving from small intestine to the body surface. That is, small intestine contains higher concentration, body contains lower concentration. It does not require energy. Which molecules are absorbed like this? Fatty acid and glycerol. Second one, facilitated diffusion. Diffusion with the help of protein molecules. Protein molecules are helping to move the substance. And which molecules are absorbed like this? Glucose, fructose, galactose, amino acids. Next one, osmosis. Absorption of water. Movement of water molecules from a region of higher concentration to a region of lower concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. It also does not require what? Energy. So water is absorbed like this. And next one, active transport. Molecules are absorbed from a region of lower concentration to higher concentration. Note that with the help of carrier proteins. As it is moving from lower to higher, it requires what? Energy. The glucose and salts are absorbed like this. So these are the 4 different types of absorption method. So all the nutrients are absorbed. Now we can use it for producing energy. One more part is there, right? Large intestine. We can see the functions of large intestine. Absorption of salt and water. It helps in absorbing salt and water. And it also helps to absorb vitamin K, which are produced by certain bacteria in the large intestine. Now, the digestive wastes stored in rectum are eliminated out through the anus. So, digestion process is over. It is necessary to regulate the intake of food. Why? It requires about 4 to 5 hours for the process of digestion. Hence, it is necessary to regulate the intake of food. That means, how many hours are needed for digesting a food? 4 to 5 hours. So we have to eat food after a gap of 4 to 5 hours. Plants do not have a digestive system, but we have a digestive system. Why? Plants prepare glucose, which itself is a simple nutrient. So there is no need of further digestion. Next, importance of roughage. Roughage means what? Fiber. Roughage or fiber in cereals and vegetables helps in absorption process. So they are helping in absorption and making the defecation easy. Thus, they protect the health of the digestive system. So we have to eat cereals and vegetables. Now, health issues created by junk food and fast food. Many health issues are there. Some are given. Obesity, digestive problem, heart disease, diabetes. Harmful chemical substances added to food to enhance its taste and color. Which are they? Different food colors are added. Some chemicals like benzoates, nitrates are added. And artificial sweeteners are added. Thank you for watching.